Okay, movement number five. It's called Repulsing the Monkey, but there's several names for that. Feet are a little bit wider than hip width, parallel. Knees bent. And you open your arms. So actually, all you do is you move from your hip. And as you do this rotation, your knees stay completely in the same spot. So all the movement happens in the hip. If you really want to practice this, then this position is the best with the index finger. So you can really see also how much movement there is in your hips. And again, make sure your knees, imagine you're buried in concrete or in earth till up to your knees, and your knees and ankles don't move at all. And the arm movements, all you're doing is you're opening up. But because you're rotating at the same time, it looks like you're doing a big twisting thing. It is also slightly twisting, but that happens quite naturally on its own. Once the arms are same level, you fold the back one towards your ear, and then you push. As if you grab, if somebody kicks, you grab their leg, and at the same time, you push against their chest. So they fall backwards. So all those movements have got a martial art application, but sometimes we switch that to things like, in this case, like imagine you're holding a ball, and that ball, out of energy, stretches out. So you can feel the threads, like a long chewing gum, and feel the connection between your hands. And that does change the hand position a little bit. The focus on really grabbing a foot and pushing against the chest, you really have to, you can't just play with a ball of chi. I mean, you can, but at the same time you need to grab the foot. Whereas if you're just focusing on the ball of chi, then your palm starts changing sooner to keep that relationship between the two hands. So that relationship, of course, is always there in the martial arts movements, but the hand position and the movement as such does change as well if your focus is different. So you inhale as you open, and you exhale as you push. Power of that push comes from your hara, from your hips, not the power of your arms. Yeah. So really get a sense of that as well. As you push, it's your hips that are behind them.